I'll just touch upon a few concepts on projectile motion, care which should be taken while solving the problems in competitive exams. Suppose I am given a situation. This is a cart from where I can launch this cannon, and this cart itself is moving with velocity u, and there is some angle theta. And it is said that it fires the cannon, it hits this body, it has some mass m, cannon has mass m. This body is also on wheels without friction, so this body will naturally start moving because of the conservation of angular momentum. And it is said that it fires cannon after time t again, and that cannon hits the body again. Again, it lands at that body. And you are given the velocity of firing of cannon as angle is given as theta, and velocity of firing is given as some v firing. So in such question, first care which you should keep, precaution which you should take is that if the velocity of firing of cannon is given, whether that velocity is in the absolute frame or it is in reference to this frame, that has to be seen. Whether this velocity is given in this frame or in absolute frame, that is first of all. Suppose that velocity is given in the frame of this, in this frame of cart, it fires with some velocity v. V of the cannon which is fired. As far as the vertical component is concerned, it will remain the same in absolute frame also because there is no velocity in the absolute frame. So v vertical in absolute frame will be vf sine theta. But v horizontal in the absolute frame will be u plus vf cos theta. Suppose it is not mentioned in this problem. Whether it is just mentioned it is fired with some velocity, this. It is not mentioned at all that this cannon is fired with this velocity in the absolute frame or in the frame of this cart. So here you can apply a checkpoint. You do it by taking it as an absolute velocity. You do it by taking as an absolute velocity and take it as absolute, and you should have one check. The check is that your horizontal velocity will be vf cos theta, will be your horizontal velocity in absolute frame. So here it is landing as at vf cos theta. Now conserve the momentum m of cannon. Let me write here m of cannon vf cos theta would be equal to m of that body vehicle which is moving, plus m which has now landed in the cannon, into the final velocity of the body. So u final is equal to m vf cos theta upon m plus m. Since it is given that the second shot which is fired also lands on the body in time t, it means the velocity which this acquires after hitting must be same as the velocity of this cannon. Unless that is there, it will not land there because in the same time it should fire from a different location. In the same time it should travel the same distance which it travels. Only then it will land at the same place. So your u final should match with u. MVF cos theta upon m plus m will be equal to u. If it is not matching, then it means you have not taken it correctly. Then apply that correction and it will be like this. Then it means the velocity which is given is not in the absolute frame, but it is given in the relative frame. Then this should give you the same value.